Since Volta microarchitecture, alongside the traditional CUDA cores, NVIDIA GPUs also have Tensor cores. We have all seen NVIDIA showing off the capabilities of Tensor cores, and I've always wondered, how can I run my own code on these Tensor cores? In my previous videos, I stuck to the CUDA cores and got a decent increase in performance. However, in this video, I will show you how we can use Tensor cores and increase the performance by another sixfold. Amazingly, we can do this in around 50 lines of code. So, without further ado, let's get started. When working with decimal numbers in a high-level language like C++, the most common way is to initialize the variable as double. The variable type dictates the space it will take in memory. For double, it's 8 consecutive bytes. However, we have another option in float, which takes 4 consecutive bytes. We can save memory by using float, but the drawback is that we only have the precision of around 7 decimal places, while with double, it's 15 to 17. Another drawback is the range of values. Float can only be used for a much smaller range of values compared to the double. Float is a common data type by working with GPUs because the range is sufficient for the tasks given and the speed up is quite significant not to be bothered about that extra level of accuracy from double. Going a step further, CUDA also provides support for half precision. The issue with half precision is that the accuracy is quite low and the final results can be useless. This is where Tensor cores shine. Using Tensor cores after accepting half precision inputs, we can get results that are very close to the accuracy provided by float. Let's now look at NVIDIA Tensor cores in a bit more detail. Tensor cores are the dedicated accelerator units on the NVIDIA GPUs that do just one thing, matrix multiplication. Having a specialized unit for just one operation is not ideal. However, matrix multiplication is a fundamental operation in machine learning and linear algebra, and the dedicated units make sense. Technically speaking, Tensor cores perform matrix multiplication and accumulation. We can set C to zeros and get matrix multiplication. Tensor cores can only do matrix multiplication, so they are restricted to certain matrix dimensions. These cores are fairly new to the NVIDIA GPUs, so we must check the documentation with almost every new software or hardware release and ensure which matrix sizes are supported. In this video, I'm going with 16x16 matrices where the input is half precision and the output is single precision, or the same as float type. In practice, we can have matrices of any dimension. For example, consider 32x32 matrices. When working with CUDA cores, we define a grid of threads such that each thread is responsible for computing an output matrix element. CUDA cores work at a level where we can control the execution of an individual thread. Tensor cores, on the other hand, work at the warp level. I've covered warp in a previous video, and if you're not familiar with thread warps, I recommend watching that as well. In short, thread in a block are bundled together into warps where each warp consists of 32 threads. As Tensor cores can only work with 16x16 matrices, we can divide this large matrix into 4 tiles, each 16x16. To compute the results, we can first load the 16x16 tiles of A and B to be used by Tensor cores. After this first set of computations, we have a partial result in the 16x16 tile of the output matrix. To get the final result, we can add the matrix of the next set of tiles to the previously computed results. The exact thing happens for all the other tiles of the matrix C in parallel. All this might look too abstract, so let's see how we can do this in code. On the hardware level, Tensor cores work alongside the thread registers. As I've mentioned earlier, Tensor cores operate at the warp level. So to keep things as simple as possible, I will create a block with just one warp and use that to compute the 16x16 tile. This might look odd, but we don't have to worry about how each thread will work here. We can generate similar thread blocks to cover the output matrix, but let's focus on one tile. Namespace NVCUDA contains all the functions necessary to work with Tensor cores. In the kernel function, we first identify which warp each thread belongs to. In the simplified case, all the threads will return the same value of variables warp m and warp n. Next, we declare fragments to store the 16x16 tiles of matrix A. This is like memory allocation for Tensor cores. The same thing is done for the matrix B tiles and the resulting tile of the output matrix, which gets initialized to all zeros. The data for these fragments is stored in the registers where the Tensor cores can access it efficiently. The next step is to use a loop and split large input matrices into multiple tiles. To copy these tiles into declared fragments, we need an address to the top left element of these tiles. Remember that while declaring the fragments, we specify 16 by 16 tiles, and CUDA provide functions that can be used as it is to copy the correct dataset from global memory to the registers. Once the tiles are loaded, matrix multiplication can be performed in a single line of code, and the partial results are stored in the accumulator. For this 32x32 example, the loop will go over the second set of tiles and we get the complete result. Once we have the results in the accumulator fragment, we get the location of the top left element of the output matrix tile and similarly copy back the results. CUDA provides convenient ways to work with tensor cores, which is a big reason for NVIDIA's success. I firmly believe that the written form is still the best for deeper understanding. For this reason, I write much more detailed blog posts accompanying the videos. For instance, in the blog post for this video, you'll find details related to the CUDA functions for declaring fragments, copying data, and matrix multiplication on tensor cores. I also explain gigaflops and why these are so common for benchmarking algorithms. If you crave more details, check it out. It's completely free. Comparing the kernel function written in this video to the one in my last video, we can see that the gigaflops using CUDA cores is significantly lower than the tensor cores. I know the kernel function I've written are not optimum, but even if I use kublas, the difference between CUDA cores and tensor cores is quite large. In the future, I would like to optimize this tensor core implementation and try to get as close as possible to the kublas version, but first, I want to do the same thing with CUDA cores. That is the topic of the next video. I want to say that I learned a lot in the past 2 months while working on that, so I can't wait to share it with you. As always, I've provided a link to the code repository in the description and the video notes are available on the website. Please let me know what you think down in the comments and I will see you next time.